As you become more familiar with the accrual basis on which the income statement is constructed, you quickly appreciate the need for a statement that focuses solely on cash and identifying the sources and uses of cash during the period. Thus, the statement of cash flow is the third statement, which is needed to complete the description of a company's financial position and performance. As I said, the purpose of the statement of cash flows is to show where the firm got cash during the year and how it was spent. In so doing, it provides an explanation of the change in the cash balance on the balance sheet from one year to the next. The bottom line figure on the statement of cash flows, the net increase or decrease in cash, should equal the change in the cash account, as you see here with Fastenal. The cash flows are classified into one of three categories: cash flows related to operating activities, cash flows related to investing activities, and cash flow related to financing activities. Operating activities are those directly related to your primary sales activities. Things like cash received from customers, cash paid to employees, suppliers, and anyone else that supports your operating activities. Investing activities capture money spent on fixed assets and investments in other companies, as well as cash received when these investments are sold. Financing activities include issuing stock, borrowing and repayment of loans, stock buybacks, and the payment of dividends to stockholders. One thing that can be a little tricky when reading a statement of cash flows is that most firms use what is called the indirect format for the statement, as opposed to the direct format. These terms, direct and indirect, refer only to how the operations section is presented. The investing and financing sections are always presented using the same format. Let me show you an example. This is what a direct format statement of cash flows looks like. The operations section is showing line items for the direct cash inflows and cash outflows, just as happens in the investing and financing sections. In the indirect format, the only thing that changes is the operations section. Now, instead of showing the operating inflows and outflows separately, the operations section begins with net income from the income statement and presents a reconciliation of net income to the actual net cash from operations. Note that the investing and financing sections are identical. Here are the two operations sections side by side. You should take a minute to study this to make sure you see that both formats arrive at the same cash flow from operations of $185,000. There are just two different ways to show the net cash generated or used from operations. Some people prefer the direct method, so they can more easily see the separate amounts of cash paid or received. Others prefer the indirect method because they like the easy comparison between net income and cash flow from operations. I should point out that with the indirect method, though, most people new to accounting find it hard to understand why certain items are added back and others subtracted. Well, it's beyond the scope of this video to go into any sort of in-depth explanation of each line item, but suffice it to say they each represent the difference between the way something is captured in net income, based on the accrual method, and its actual cash flow. For example, take depreciation expense. Depreciation, as we've seen, is a normal expense on the income statement that reduces net income. However, it doesn't use any cash. No cash is paid out when depreciation expense is recognized. So cash flow from operations will always be more than net income by the amount of depreciation expense. In order to adjust or reconcile net income to cash flow, then we must add back depreciation expense. That's the sort of thing that is happening with each line item. For our purposes in this segment, your focus when viewing an indirect cash flow statement should really be on the relation between net income and cash flow from operations. One would hope that over time, the pluses and minuses would average out, and there'd be a pretty strong relationship between net income and cash flow. If cash flow from operations starts to decline without a similar decline in net income, that could be a red flag that the firm is having a hard time collecting cash from its customers or, even worse, maybe manipulating the financial numbers. The statement of cash flow is really needed to complete the financial picture of the firm. The balance sheet lists the company's resources and the claims on those resources at a single point in time. Thus, it becomes important to compare the end of the year balance sheet with the beginning of the year balance sheet to identify changes and to see if and where the firm is growing. The income statement is necessary to provide more detail on the operations of the firm, how well it did during the year at selling its products and services. And the statement of cash flow provides direct insight into where we got our cash and how it was spent. The key takeaway is that you cannot rely on any one of these statements alone to fully evaluate a firm's financial health. You really have to examine all three and understand the different insights each statement can provide.